Disclaimer: if you do not participate in Halloween activities due to religious or family beliefs, you do not have to do the following activities listed below in today's lesson: Monster Mash Dance, Spooky Scary Skeletons Dance, or the Halloween Example Instrument Story. But you do need to create your own instrument story, since that is not required to be Halloween related. All right, let's dance.
I was working in the lab late one night. My eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slayer began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
Monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from their humble abodes to get a jolt from my electrodes.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the monster mash. The zombies were having the party had just begun. The guests included Wolfman, Dracula, and his son. The scene was rocking over, digging the sound. Igor on chains backed by his baying hound. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker 5. They played the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the monster mash. Out from his coffin, Drax's voice did ring. Seems he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, "Whatever happened to my transmission in the
east?" It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash.
The monster mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
It's now the mash.
It's now the monster mash. Now everything's cool, Drax a part of the band. And my monster mash is the hit of the land. If you're living, this mash was meant to. When you get to my door, tell them what they sent you.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash.
The monster mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can monster mash. That's good. Easy, Igor. You can get yourself a boy. That's good.
Let's do another dance.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons and speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek. We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think they should.
A spooky, scary skeleton shouts startling, chilly screams. They'll sneak under sarcophagus and just won't leave you be.
Spooky, scary, spooky, scary, spooky, scary, spooky, scary, 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 scary.
Spirits supernatural are charlatans all of us. But acts of bones seem so unsafe and semi-serious. Spooky, scary skeletons are silly all the same. They smile and scrabble slowly by and drive you so
insane.
Sticks and stones will pick up on me, so don't let you snooze. And spooky, scary skeletons will wake you through the wind.
Last one.
strange in a neighborhood. Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
If there's something weird and it don't look good, who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
Hey y'all, today we're going to be doing something a little special because it's Halloween week. And so we're going to be creating an instrument story. And I'm going to give you an example. And this is the story we do every year. So if you've been in my class before, you know what it is. It's a little special thing we do with orph instruments every year. And so in this story, each character has a different instrument that's going to represent them. And so like the marimbas, the wooden xylophones, are going to be pumpkins. The metallophones, the metal xylophones, are going to be the sun. The tubanos, the drums, are going to be the bad witch. The chime tree is going to be the fairy. And the scraper, the giro, is going to be the knife. And the thunder tube is going to be the storm. And so each time they're mentioned in the story, they're going to play for 2 or 3 seconds, okay, based on what their character is doing. So if their character is sneaking up on somebody, they're going to play softly or slowly. If their character is screaming and crying for help, then they're going to play more forcefully, but they're not going to abuse their instrument. Okay. We never cross that line where they're abusing their instrument. At the beginning of the story, I'm going to say once there was a witch, were pumpkins in the pumpkin patch. And so I'm going to introduce each character and you'll see which sections are representing which character. Okay. So this is Miss Adair's class and I hope you enjoy. This is the Halloween instrument story.
Hey y'all, we have special guests today. This is Miss Adair's homeroom class, 5th grade, and they've volunteered to do the Halloween story for you today. So I hope you enjoy it. They're gonna show you how it's done. All right, let's go. Once upon a time, there was a bad witch. There are some pumpkins in the pumpkin patch. It was a sunny day. There was a fairy. And there was a storm brewing in the distance. On this sunny day, the pumpkins laid out in the pumpkin patch. And suddenly, a witch appeared. And with her, she brought a horrible storm of wind and rain. And the wind started ripping the leaves off and denting the pumpkins, and the pumpkins were screaming and crying for help. And so a fairy appeared. And whenever the fairy came, the witch ran off into the storm. And then the sun came back out. And the pumpkins felt so much better. But the witch was not done. She decided to sneak up. And she brought with her a knife. And she started carving mean faces at all the pumpkins. The pumpkins were screaming and crying for help. But the fairy was not going to let her get away with it. She snuck up behind her and took a giant hollowed-out pumpkin and popped it onto the witch's head. And the witch couldn't see, she couldn't hear, she started screaming and waving her arms and ran off. And the fairy had saved the day, which made the pumpkins feel so much better. And they continued to lay out in the sun for the rest of the day. And everyone except the witch lived happily ever after. Very good. The end. All right, I hope you enjoyed it. That is the Halloween story on orchestra instruments. Bye, guys.
All right, what did you think about it? I hope you enjoyed it. The kids playing enjoyed it. I enjoyed narrating it, and I hope you enjoyed watching it. So now what I want you to do is to go and create your own instrument story. It doesn't have to be Halloween related. It can be a fall story. It could be anything you want, as long as it's appropriate. That's the big thing. So you find instruments around your house. You could use instruments, or you could homemade kind of instruments, like pots and pans and bowls and boxes and wooden spoons and metal spoons. Like, there's all different kinds of things. Rice you could use as a shaker. All different options for instruments at home. And let's say you have, let's do like five different kinds of things. Okay, so you got like a metal, a wood, a plastic, a rubber, a, like I said, a food, like a rice shaker or something like that. So find five things around the house and then create a story where you use each of those sounds as a character in the story. Okay. And after you say each character and what they did, just pause and play, or have people play. You could do all the instruments. You could be the narrator and have other people do the instruments. You could do both narrator and instruments. There's all kinds of options for your story. So, but I want you to create a story, be creative and use your imagination. It can be made up. It can be a real story. It could be magical. It could be realistic. Your choice, what kind of story you want it to be. But be sure you use the instruments and kind of base it off of what you think it could actually sound like. So for instance, like in our story that you just saw, the fairy was a chime tree, which had that magical feel to it, or sound to it. And the witch was the drums, which are really hard. And so use something that kind of sounds like, we have a thunder tube as the storm, just like that. So But have fun with it, be creative. And then I want to see your story. So if you could record it somehow, I'd appreciate it, or have someone record you do it. But I want to see it. So I'm really excited to see him. So if you could upload it straight to this assignment, just a video straight to the assignment, that would be awesome. So, I really want to see it, but you have a lot of options. Just make sure it's appropriate. Nothing gory. Okay. Like in our story, we had a knife, but the knife was not hurting anybody. The knife was carving pumpkins, which is what they're meant for a lot of the time, and especially during fall or during October. So nothing gory or inappropriate like that. All right. If you're uncomfortable creating your own story, then you could always use instruments and apply it to my story that I had created. But that is six instruments. So there's six characters in my story. So you have the witch, the sun, the pumpkins, the fairy, the knife, and the storm. Okay. So all you have to do is replay my story, or you could narrate my story. It's not hard. It's not hard to remember. And then play your instruments after those specific characters, but you assign each instrument to a character. Okay. Have fun with it and be creative. Okay. I can't wait to see your videos. All right. Thanks, guys.
Have fun creating your instrument story. I can't wait to see it. Happy Halloween!